बोर्ड लाइट शाइनिंग इन एवरी किचन, बोर्ड लाइट एम्ब्रेसिंग ऑल इन ईच हु फील्स हिमसेल्फ एज वन विद बी नो ही इज आल्सो वन विद एवरीवन। सो वेलकम फ्रेंड्स वंस मोर। टुडे we're going to celebrate Dr. Annie Besant's day. She was born on 1st of October 1847, and Shankar Lodge is going to celebrate, and we have a very distinguished speaker, Brother C.S. Shinde, who will speak on Annie Besant and practical brotherhood. I'll just introduce, although all of us we know about Brother Shinde, yet I must introduce so that if there is any new member or the others who don't know much about him will also come to know about him. Brother C.A. Shinde retired as a zoology professor from Sangli and Pune, and he worked in Maharashtra for 37 years. He is an author of 10 textbooks in zoology for undergraduate students. He has been a life member of Theosophical Society, rendering a service to Theosophical Society since 1975. He has conducted many seminars, School of Wisdom, workers training camps, study classes at various places throughout India as National Lecturer of Indian Section. His many articles have been published in Theosophist, Wake Up India, Theosophical Digest, The Indian Theosophist, and many other Federation journals. He has given many short talks and participated in international symposiums during conventions at ADIA. He has compiled the Watchtower articles of Mrs. Radha Bernier, which is published as a book titled The World Around Us. Now, he is a resident of ADIA as the librarian of the ADIA Library and Research Center and secretary of Alcott Memorial High School. He also participates in various activities in India. He is a member of General Council member. He is a member of General Council and Executive Council. And he is also an international speaker who has visited Sri Lanka and Kotala. So with this introduction, I will request Brother C. S. Shindeji to please start his lecture on Annie Besant and practical brotherhood. Over to you.
Thank you, Rajiv Gupta ji. I really thanks all the brothers and sisters of Shankar Lodge, Delhi, and also Delhi Federation for inviting me to share some thoughts on the eve of birth anniversary, 174th birth anniversary of Dr. Annie Besant. In fact, we celebrate 2nd October Mahatma Gandhi's birth anniversary as well as Lal Bahadur Shastri's birth anniversary, remembering all these great souls. I was much impressed. Let me tell you, here there are many learned people, many serious people who have been working for the Theosophical Society, who have been studying Theosophy deeply. And today's topic is practical brotherhood. And when we think of practical brotherhood, we really remember the life of Dr. Annie Besant. I am emphasizing this because she gave us a mantra. And that mantra is, usually we chant in the beginning of the any function, and that is the universal prayer. And she spoke about the hidden life, hidden light, hidden love. I was deeply contemplating on these three, why she gave this. We all are studying yoga, etc. And in this also, dharana, dhyan, samadhi, these three leads to our union of individual consciousness with the universal consciousness. That's what we study, we contemplate, try to understand deeply the meaning of that. So these three steps are very important in the sense. Hello, I am in the meeting now. I am in the meeting. So these three steps we have to understand. When dharana gets perfected, it converts into dhyana. When dhyana gets perfected, it converts into samadhi. And when samadhi we achieve, we become one with the universal consciousness. This is what, these are the steps. That is what we study, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. What is our dharana? Dharana is that which we believe. What we are believing, that we become. So we believe in practical brotherhood, we believe in universal brotherhood as the members of the Theosophical Society. And if that belief is really a true belief, then perhaps we can understand what Dr. Bejent wants to say us to go through this foundation of the universal brotherhood towards the destiny of human life, that is yoga, union. So with this foundation, we can reach to that union of individual consciousness with the universal consciousness. And for this, she gave this mantra, O hidden life, O hidden love, O hidden light. I am beginning with this only because we also study. We know from where we get the energy. We speak about the spiritual source of energy or energy source in our body. And we know we get energy from food. And we also get energy from the outer surrounding. So we say, we get energy from the earth beneath and from the heaven above. It's true. And we can intellectualize it. Definitely we are getting energy from the sun. Without the sun, there will not be any photosynthesis, no food, nothing else. In the same manner, in our body, we need food energy also for the synthesis of all cells which are going on in our body. So it is true that we draw energy from earth beneath and energy from the heaven above. And our heart is full of life and love. That is what we invoke. So the heart is full of life and love. Again, these two terms, life and love. If the heart is full of life and love, we are having mind to think, body to serve others, and heart to feel and harmonize. So if we are really equipped with these three things, then the question is, are we really using those three things which are provided by the in the course of evolution for the human body? And we may ask also, who knows? Who knows in me? Who knows the truth? And when we think deeply on this, it is not the mind that knows. Mind thinks, analyzes, criticizes, and goes deeper and deeper. So the Function of the mind is thinking, analyzing, appreciating the truth that it sees. But who knows the truth? It is not the mind. Mind only thinks and appreciates. Even it is not the heart, but heart only feels. So when the mind thinks and the heart feels and the body is for the service of others with the energy that it gets from the below and above, then who knows? The question is, who knows actually? And the answer to this, it is not the body, it is not the mind, it is not the heart, but it is the intuition that knows, prajna. So we have to reach to that prajnavastha, state of prajna, intuition. And to reach that state of intuition, how can we raise? And in our theosophical emblem, we have two triangles. One triangle is pointing downwards, the other triangle is pointing outwards. Downward, and the other one is upward. That which is pointing downward is the indication of involution, and upward is the evolution that we usually explain, and it is already explained like this. And when I was thinking about the elements, the influence of elements on our energy sources, which are spiritual energy sources that are present in our body, and the lower triangle that is pointing towards the downward, it is influenced by the earth, water, fire and air. These four elements are influencing this lower triangle. And these four elements are wonderfully conducting the activities of the body, keeping it healthy and helping or giving us all kind of physiological security to the body. So this lower triangle is controlled by earth, water, air, fire. And in this triangle, 3 points, below is earth and above 2 points are the water and fire. And in the middle, there is the air. And that middle point is the heart point. It is this heart point where Dr. Annie Besant told us to meditate in the heart. Why? Because heart chakra or heart energy center is influenced by the element air. And we all know the significance of prana. It is not only the oxygen, but all other pranas, I am not going to explain that. It is definitely that prana, air element, is influencing the heart chakra. So when we meditate in the heart, and in this heart, as I in the beginning told, it is full of life and love. As I said, we draw energy from above heaven and earth beneath, and my heart is full of love and life. Here, this prana is directly concerned with the life. Without prana, there cannot be life. And this life is this prana shakti, is this oxygen We know now in this pandemic period the importance of oxygen is supplied to each and every corner of the body by whom? It is the heart which pumps the blood. And the blood that carries oxygen to each and every cell of the body. Exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide takes place and again it is thrown out through the lungs. So in this water, air element, prana, is influencing our heart. And if we meditate in the heart and we really raise our consciousness by meditating in the heart, then perhaps whatever triangle I told you, which is downwardly pointed, may make a miracle. It becomes upwardly pointed because we raise our consciousness from these earth, water, air, earth, water, fire, and air. And through air, we raise our consciousness to the fifth element, that is the ether, space. Ether, akasha, prithvi of tej vayu, and akasha. So the upper triangle, which is in our emblem, is nothing but this space, nothing but this ether element. And ether is very important element because it is the source of all other elements. And when we meditate in the heart, and when we say, oh hidden life, oh hidden light, oh hidden love, that meditation itself raises our consciousness towards this ether. And if we really know something basic about these energy sources in our body, chakras, so above these four chakra, fifth chakra is the kantha chakra, throat. And when we reach to that throat, and there throat is influenced by the space, that is akash tattva. And unless that makes opening to this prana, the air cannot go inside. Air cannot go to the lungs unless that throat point is opened. Otherwise, we were not breathing in the womb of the mother. When we come out of the womb, we required first that air to take in. And who opened that throat? It is a miracle. It happened. And the air start going within. And this air going within began in the beginning of our life. So this life principle entered through this throat, and then we started exchanging oxygen and carbon dioxide, and the life went on. So this is how this space element is important when we reach to that chakra. And above that, and this chakra, thought, this above that is the pineal gland, that is the pituitary body, pineal gland, all these I am not going to see. So that is more important for the thought, because air element, this ether element is required for the thought transformation and all that. So when we say, oh hidden life, vibrant in every atom, that prana is activated, and prana is circulated throughout the body, and energy is distributed throughout the body. So life becomes active. Life becomes vibrant. Then when we say, oh, hidden light shining in every creature, we raise our consciousness to that sixth and seventh energy sources, which are Vishuddhi Chakra and Ajna Chakra. They purify our thought. Thoughts become noble. Why? Because we begin to see clearly. That clarity comes, and therefore thought is changed. It becomes clear thought. This is how the influence of this ether element, and that thought is energy. With that thought, we shine. So, oh, hidden light shining in every creature. That light of Vivek Buddhi that comes there. And who knows? In the beginning I asked, it is not the thought, it is not the heart, but it is the intuition that knows. And intuition is the prajna. So when with this ether element, when throat chakra and ajna chakra are activated, we invite that intuition, and it is that intuition which knows the truth. It is this process. Truth is oneness of life, realization of oneness of life, and therefore the third sentence is, oh hidden love. So when we say, when we reach to the prajna, prajna is nothing but that love. We can't define prajna. It is the love, it is the compassion. And oh hidden love, embracing all in oneness. If you really reach to that, if you really know that, then any agent invokes one who feels himself as one with thee. No, he is also one with every other. And once you realize that you are one with the universal consciousness, then keep it up. Don't forget, or don't be with yourself. Know that you are one with all others. This is a wonderful mantra. I think today only I felt more about it. Why not we can speak on this? This mantra is a wonderful mantra that takes us to the destiny of the human life, which is Tasmat Yogi Bhava. We can become the one with the universal consciousness if we really think and deeply meditate on this mantra of, oh hidden life, oh hidden light, oh hidden love. And when we say we draw energy from the heaven above and earth beneath, and our heart is full of life and love. But we require that light which is shining in every creature, and therefore we must raise to that ether element. Only then we reach to the prajna, and then that hidden love which is in our heart, that start feeling oneness with the other. And practical brotherhood, which is the topic of today, it is to realize, it is not only to speak. One has to go deeper into oneself to realize this universal brotherhood is a noble thought. Well, as I said, both Dr. Annie Besant and Mahatma Gandhi, they worked together really with national and social spirit. No doubt Gandhiji worked on breaking down the caste system, and more importantly, untouchability. Because that period, untouchability was prevailing in the civilization. Dr. Annie Besant also worked to reform the caste system and taught Sanatana Dharma, Manavata Dharma. So let me tell you, both Dr. Annie Besant and Mahatma Gandhi worked on some other social customs as well, like dowry, sati, pardha, child widows, child marriage, etc., etc. This won't come unless there is principle of practical brotherhood begins to work. And it is in both of them, this practical brotherhood principle was working, and that was expressed through their work to as a social reformers. And one more thing I would like to mention here. Both were, even if we are thinking that they are having difference of opinion, maybe having opinions may be different, but one postcard appreciating the work of Dr. Annie Besant is sent by the Mahatma Gandhi, and in 1924 that postcard was sold for 20,233 dollars, and this was reported by PTI in 1924. See what that letter was containing. Gandhi wrote that postcard. He writes about Annie Besant as an Irish origin. Yes, she was Irish origin. Gandhiji writes, an Irish origin social reformer who became a leader of the Indian freedom movement. See, Gandhiji accepted this. She was the leader of the Indian freedom movement. We may not be fully accept, but Mahatma Gandhi accepted, and he wrote a postcard, and that postcard was sold for $20,233 of this Mahatma Gandhi's letter to Annie Besant. So let me say, there is even difference in their faith. Both had faith in religion, no doubt. Which religion? The highest religion is the humanity, Manavata Dharma. Both they were having faith in religion. But for M.K. Gandhi, truth was God. And for Annie Besant, truth was the highest religion, Satyanasti Paro Dharma. For Mahatma Gandhi, truth was God. You must act like God. You should not do any kind of sin in your life. God never does any sin. So, he propagated this seven sins of Mahatma Gandhi, we know well. I repeat, because this is good to repeat. Politics without principles is a social sin. Wealth without work is a social sin. Pleasure without conscience, knowledge without character, commerce without morality, and science without humanity. And finally, if you are in a spiritual path, worship without sacrifice is also a social sin. And when Jai Krishnamurti says we have a common ground of human consciousness, common ground or common field of human consciousness. So what we think, what we feel, what we do, sin, all that is added to that common ground, and we are subjected to the common karma. So in this way, we also remember Mahatma Gandhi on 2nd October, and the 1st October we celebrate birth anniversary of Dr. Besant, who is the second president of the International Theosophical Society from 1907 to 1933. Annie Besant, in the light of Theosophical or in Theosophical light, in that light of truth, she lived. In the light of that truth, she died on 20th September 1933. In the light of truth, we believe she, even now, she lives in an even greater life and for the cause of truth. And nowadays, many young ladies are taking part with the spirit of Annie Besant. And I think she is working through these souls. Hope she will return in the future to bless and to bring the world to still greater height, greater light, greater vision. You know, Dr. Besant herself believed that beyond and behind of all our efforts, beyond and behind of all our efforts, there was a power. She believed in it. There was a power behind all her efforts. And that power was invisible power. And it is ceaselessly working. She never for a single moment doubted about such kind of authenticity of power behind her. And therefore, she had a mission. The master had a plan for her. And that mission was Indian mission. And that Indian mission is to get freedom for India. And in this mission, many great spiritual leaders shared their energy, efforts, and to name them, like Swami Vivekananda, Sri Aurobindo, Rabindranath Tagore, Mahatma Gandhi, all of them, they worked for this mission. Who was behind this mission? It is not the Annie Besant. And as Mahatma Gandhi said, she was the leader of freedom of India. So when we say father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi, and this father says she was the leader for freedom of India, then I really believe that that invisible power behind all her effort, there was that power ceaselessly working. Oh, second important thing she did in her life, that is the discovery of Krishnamurti. J. Krishnamurti is the highest proof of Annie Besant's prophetic vision. And Krishnamurti himself was the living proof of his own teaching. What Annie Besant, it is not that Annie Besant was not believing in the God. She said in public, if he is on God's side, he is one of us. If he is on God's side, he is one of us. And then it does not matter in the least whether he calls himself a Hindu or a Buddhist or a Christian or a Mohammedan, whether he is an Indian or an Englishman, a Chinaman or a Russian. It does not matter in her mission. This is how she was a real leader to involve all men and women without any kind of distinctions like caste, creed, sex, all that. That is what the practical brotherhood she taught by her efforts and her life. So unless our, she said, I quote her, unless our hearts are throbbing with sympathy, unless we feel as they feel and see as they see, we cannot help people. It's very important. Unless our hearts are throbbing with sympathy and feel as they feel and see as they see, we cannot help people. Because then we do not help them from outside, but from inside. As we enter more and more into their hearts and minds and live on that plane, then perhaps we pour our strength into them and enable them to share in that which we have achieved. This is what it is reflected in her universal prayer, as I said. Once you achieve that one, may each who feels himself as one with thee, then perhaps he can become one with the others. So what we have achieved, how we can give it to the others, that is what the practical brotherhood she taught to us. All Annie Besant's lectures were really, really inspiring because she was sure what she was telling. There is no failure when there is divine architect of the universe behind you. And if you are assisting the divine plan in evolution, then there is no failure. There is no failure because victory is always on divine side. Then what happens? She asks, then what happens if our tiny schemes of a movement are found to be useless in that divine plan? Doesn't matter, but try. What matters in our efforts then? When the life we have thrown into them, it's also a question. If our plans are become useless in their plans, then what is the use to do the efforts? Then answer she gives, the life we have thrown into them, the devotion with which we planned them, the strength with which we carried them, and sacrifice which we offer to the success of the mighty whole, that efforts, that spiritual effort definitely enrolls us as sacrificial workers with the masters. So no spiritual endurance, spiritual effort goes in vain. She insisted in her talk. Although we are independent, free agent in nature, as said by H.P. Blavatsky in The Voice of the Silence, we do have choice, but that choice must not be selfish. For practical brotherhood, therefore, Annie Besant emphasized self-control. She said, self-control is an admirable quality. It is a stage through which every man must pass. So we have to control ourselves because we are affected by the animal passions and all those five elements which I said in the beginning, we have collected for the involution. So Theosophy for practical brotherhood propagates good conduct, and qualifications mentioned in the at the feet of the master are self-control as the mind, self-control as the action, tolerance, cheerfulness, one-pointedness, confidence. All these are mentioned in the at the feet of the master, and also in the ancient wisdom they are mentioned as sama, dama, titiksha, uparati, shraddha, samadhana. All these are really, really helpful for self-control. And nowadays, in the present day, yama niyama of Patanjali Yoga Sutra are must. We have to do that. Without those yama niyama, we cannot treat the spiritual path. So this perfect self-control is threefold, said Anibhajan. The perfect self-control is threefold. What is that threefold? Control in thought, speech, and action. So it is threefold in this. Speaking about brotherhood of men, Anibhajan said, to bring practical brotherhood in life, remember, it is not possible unless one learns to activate buddhic principle. That is what in the beginning of my lecture I said, if we meditate in the heart and go to raise to that buddhic principle, that is what Anibhajan insisted. This buddhic principle in man is a principle of unifying. There is unity. And that unity drawing the separated together. So using this buddhic principle, we can explain it in simple words. The man who is pure, if his buddhic principle is active, then this pure man takes his purity to the foul. The man who is wealthy, if the buddhic principle is active in him, he uses his wealth for the benefit of poor. And the man who is learned and this buddhic principle is activated, he begins to teach the ignorant. Likewise, to be brotherly is the noblest thing on the earth, and it is the characteristic feature of the sixth sub-race, which is beginning now. And our international efforts are towards this spiritual self-transformation and to reach towards this intuition. And it is only then we learn the lesson of togetherness. We learn the ancient wisdom teaching of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, and practical brotherhood idea is then linked with this of equality. But unfortunately, lot of inequality is still there. Lot of pioneering work has to be done by the Theosophical Society and members of the society. So to sum up, I think I have to show you one video also, because Dr. Anibhajan, she not only loved the men, but she loved all plants and animals. And still what she started, the animal dispensary, it is wonderfully working now in the Adyar. And that animal dispensary, what we do here, how they work. Now ultrasonic mission is also brought to treat the animals, diseases, etc. This is how her work is still going on. So to sum up, Dr. Anibhajan, through the universal prayer, O hidden love embracing all in oneness, is itself a practical brotherhood that transcends our smallness, pettiness of our mind, and also it sublimes the senses and the urges of the senses. It fills our heart with love towards all sentient and non-sentient beings and things. It is the feeling of goodwill for all. It is also reverence for all life. Even to love one's enemy, there has to be charitable disposition. One has to develop sportsmanship attitude with no jealousy, no narrow-mindedness, no competition and comparison, to be considerate with large-heartedness. In childhood, children are definitely large-hearted and also pure-hearted. But as we grow, our heart starts shrinking and become impure because it gets motivated by selfishness. At the same time, or simultaneously, heart shrinks, but the brain develops in size. Brain grows in size with its cerebral patterns of behavior. And all our thoughts move towards in a conditioned groove. It is therefore to realize practical brotherhood of humanity or to form the nucleus of universal brotherhood that becomes very difficult because our heart is not pure. Brain has got the cerebral patterns of behavior. So to bring the practical brotherhood seems to be difficult. But just begin to count your blessings. What I say, if we begin to count our blessings, then we will see nothing is ours. All is given by God. It is not our effort, but His benevolence that grants us to wake up from sleep. Otherwise, sleep is the other side of the physical death. So for practical brotherhood, we must learn to avoid all kinds of excesses, not to live beyond one's means, which means to learn need-based living and not greed-based living, is in true sense practical brotherhood. Clean life involves to be a man of character and noble deeds. Earning by honest means, sharing with less fortune. So all these are the points which we, let us remember today at least. They remind us by the life of Dr. Annie Besant. I thank all brothers for giving me this opportunity to speak on today, even it is 2nd October. I included both Mahatma Gandhi and Annie Besant, how they work together. They showed practical brotherhood in their living. Thank you, Gupta ji. And now you can show that BMAD video if you able to show. Thank you very much to all of you.
Thank you, brother. Thank I'll just you. First I'll show the video which you have sent, and then
video.
The, yes, okay. First the video, then the PowerPoint which you have sent. Both.
This is how we feed into the campus. You can put to the corner. These are the some of the Annie Besant pictures which are really inspiring. This is on 20th September 1933, cremation at our Adyar campus. Garden of Remembrance is built on this. Headquarter, you know all, Annie Besant's first. This is how these two souls, they work together for freedom of India. Mahatma Gandhi and Annie Besant. Very rare photo. This is, I visited the Banaras Hindu University, Madan Mohan Malviya. And when I went inside, there is one carving or phototype on the pillar of the building. Next you can show. I am standing there in the Madan Mohan Malviya statue. This is what? In one of the pillars, if you go there in the Banaras Hindu University, and it is there, Srimati Basanti, you can read that one, Gupta ji?
Sure.
So here, Annie Besant's photo.
Gita ki bhakt, Hindu dharm premi, Hindu college.
Yeah, Srimati Basant Devi.
Basanti Devi.
Basant Devi. Who is the bhakt of Bhagavad Gita. That is what it is written.
Yes.
So this is important document on the pillar there. So Banaras people, they know well what Annie Besant did in the education. This is in Karnataka, Annie Besant's bust, where our international president with his wife Lily visited, and garland is put. This is that bust in Karnataka, and in even in Delhi Federation is also there is one bust, no?
Yeah, we have a whole statue there. The Federation is all there.
Buddha statue and Annie Besant is there. Yeah, yeah. This is in the, when you go to the Chennai railway station, on the way you can see Besant's Marina Beach. You can see, because he is very well known in the south. Though she was loving north, she was well known in south. She did a lot because Congress party started after the convention here at south. And she was popular here in the south. Well, this is the, after discovery of Krishnamurti, he is giving lecture in Guindy, Chennai. Dr. Besant and Krishnaji at the Star Camp, Guindy, Adyar, January. It is 1929. Yeah, 1929. Rare photos. Just I want to show it today. I think we finished, no? Oh, this is again in 1926. She founded the foundation stone laid by Dr. Annie Besant in Rajahmundry. A very old lodge is there, wonderful lodge we visited. Narayanan was standing there. Next you can show. Yes, we all gathered there and we saw that lodge. We discussed with them. This is how, and there is one plaque. This is also in 1926. She laid the foundation stone for our Pune Theosophical Lodge, Marathi Federation. This is Rabindranath Tagore visited Adyar, and during that time, Rabindranath Tagore and Annie Besant, they are together along with the all dignitaries and Theosophical leaders. Even Arundel is also there. This is Mahatma Gandhi visited Adyar This is near Banyan Tree, and Kasturba is also there. On left side, there is Annie Besant sitting. So Mahatma Gandhi and Kasturba, both of them visited to Adyar. This is Garden of Remembrance. Whenever you come to Adyar, do visit this place. It is a very much magnetized place, and that gives you energy. This is universal prayer. Finished. Thank you. Thank you very much, Gupta ji. Yes, somebody is asking some.
Yes, I am Aban Patel.
Yeah, Aban Patel, thank you. You are from Bombay.
Yes, yeah. You have opened up a new horizon for me, at least.
Thank you, madam.
By giving the in-depth meaning of our universal prayer.
Thank you.
But
thank you.
I'm so sorry, I could not write down everything which you were speaking. Yeah, will you be able to give us some source from where I can get this?
You won't get, just I gave those thoughts. You can think over it.
No, but the thing is that, sir, it was so well.
I will give you, if you call me, I will tell you. It is not.
Because,
it.
You know, we are on WhatsApp also and Facebook also. And if you can, I will give you my, what is your ID, yeah. Email ID?
CAShinde22@gmail.com.
CAShinde.
CAShinde22.
Yes.
@gmail.com.
Okay, but all small case.
All small.
Okay, I will write to you.
Thank you.
On email, and you can give me that.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Shindeji, I can also give to her.
Hello.
Because I was really amazed, because I did not know the depth of this prayer that we do so regularly. But I mean, we knew overall, but the way you explained, it was really very good. I have written it in my messages.
Good. Thank
but
you.
I said, okay, the message may not be read by you, so let me talk about it. And yeah. I will send you on CA.
Good thing you talk, because I don't read messages. Good thing you talk.
Exactly. Anyway, thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
We are really enlightened. And thank you, the Northern...
Gupta ji.
Aapka bhi bahut shukriya. For having such a wonderful meeting today at this time.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Just for everybody's knowledge, our lecture here today is recorded and will be posted on YouTube channel Theosophy Delhi. So all the lectures are there. You can go through these lectures and you can take down whatever notes you want to take down.
That is fine.
Theosophy
Delhi.
Delhi. Okay.
Gupta ji, I'll send it to her, Abanji. Don't
okay.
worry.
Okay, thank you.
Because brother Taral and I are all the time in conversation with each other. Okay, thank you very much, sir. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, brother Shindeji. Is there anyone else who would like to ask a question or say something else on the topic? You're most welcome. Brother Lokhande is there. Brother Lokhande ji, would you like to say? Kuch aap bolna chahenge? Bhaskar Tendulkar ji is also there. Brother, he is also there. Dr. Satsangi.
Hello. Ha. Gupta ji, namaskar.
Namaskar.
Hello. हाँ, अभी शिंदे जी का लेक्चर बहुत ही बढ़िया रहा, और जो हमारी यूनिवर्सल प्रार्थना है उसका जो हिडन मीनिंग था, डीप मीनिंग था, वो उन्होंने बहुत अच्छी तरह से बताया है, बहुत सारी बातें हमारे भी ख्याल में आ गई है। इसके लिए शिंदे जी को धन्यवाद देता हूँ, और आपने जो अरेंज किया इस टाइप का प्रोग्राम ये बहुत अच्छा हुआ। साथ में जो पिक्चराइजेशन आपने बताया उनकी याद में, वो उनकी स्मृति को फिर से ताजा करने के लिए कारगर सिद्ध हुआ। इसके लिए आयोजकों को भी मैं धन्यवाद देता हूँ। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
धन्यवाद अशोक जी।
थैंक यू लोखंडे जी। लोखंडे जी, ये पूरा का पूरा जो श्रेय है ये ब्रदर माथुर जी को जाता है। उन्होंने
माथुर जी तो माथुर जी है क्या?
माथुर जी अभी दिल्ली से बाहर हैं, तो अभी नहीं नहीं कर पाए हैं।
चलो अच्छा है, उनसे भी बात कर लेंगे। बहुत बढ़िया रहा आज का एनी लेजेंड की स्मृति में, बहुत अच्छा रहा।
मैं दो शब्द कहना चाहूंगी। नमस्कार।
नमस्कार। नमस्कार
ब्रदर शिंदे, जस्ट फॉर योर इन्फॉर्मेशन, आई डोंट नो इफ मैनी पीपल नो इट, ये जो हमारी यूनिवर्सल प्रेयर है ये इंद्रप्रस्थ स्कूल की प्रिंसिपल ने, वो स्कूल को पेंट कराना चाहती थी। तो देखा कि स्कूल में बहुत सारे सिंबल्स बने हुए हैं, वहाँ के हॉल्स में बहुत सिंबल्स हैं, पूरा जो चौक है ना, चौक का एरिया। तो वो समझी नहीं ये क्यों है, क्योंकि ये जो बिल्डिंग है ये एक फिलोसोफिस्ट थे, मुझे ब्रदर का नाम याद नहीं है, उन्होंने स्कूल को डोनेट की थी और यहाँ पर गर्ल्स स्कूल स्टार्ट किया गया था। ऑफकोर्स प्रेरणा थी डॉक्टर रेनी बेसेंट। तो पेंट कराने के समय जब पेंटर्स उस पर लगाने लगे कलर, उस समय में उस स्कूल में पढ़ती थी।
अच्छा।
तो उन्होंने पूछा मत लगाइए क्यों, तो जो अपनी सोसाइटी के मेंबर्स थे उन्होंने जाके बताया कि ये सारे हमारे थियोसोफिकल सिंबल्स हैं, एंड दे वर द सिंबल्स ऑफ एडवांस्ड स्टेज प्रैक्टिशनर्स, मिसोनिक्स एंड ऑल अबव। तो उन्होंने नहीं लगाया, उस समय उन्हें इस प्रेयर के बारे में पता चला।
अच्छा।
एंड सिंस देन शी इंक्लूडेड दिस प्रेयर in our daily school prayers, and this used to be the last prayer. और आज जिस तरह से आपने इसको unfold किया, the levels of consciousness, though we have been doing it, you know,
yes,
for 6 to 7 years continuously daily, I was leading the prayers there, or and this used to be the last prayer in the school, along with all Saraswati Vandana and all. So, but यहाँ भी
I am also happy to inform you.
Yes.
Yesterday I received one video, and where on Annie Besant Day this universal prayer was chanted in a military school.
Wow.
Conducted by Chhapra Theosophical Society, and Suresh ji is there. His son is in military, and he used to conduct this. There, and that video is there. I have preserved that video.
Very nice.
Where one person was saying, "Oh, hidden life," and all were chanting. Wonderful. I shared that. Tomorrow I will share with on WhatsApp.
Sure.
Video, so, and same, I have kept it on the Facebook also.
Correct. So same way.
This prayer has becoming more and more popular in nowadays in the schools also.
Like we are following it right from, you know, 70s and earlier, 60s, 70s. Yeah. Since then, but the real meaning, the spirit behind the words,
yes.
Today you have really unfolded so very nicely. Thank you very much for that.
Malti Pandurang, something want to tell? Malti ji, you can unmute and tell. Unmute, you have to unmute and tell. No, okay.
Tarun, okay, sir.
Namaste.
Namaste, all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay.
Brother Bhaskar Tendulkar ji, you are also there. Dr. Sasangi ji, you are also there. Would you like to contribute a little bit? One thing I'll say, Brother Shindeji, what I've heard, because I used to go regularly to Indraprastha Lodge, that is the school that sister was talking about. And what I've heard is that when Dr. Annie Besant wanted to start a girls' school, and she wanted the education for the girls, so she asked this person who was the owner of this building. It was actually a haveli, a place where they used to live, a very big place. And that person donated the whole haveli for the school to be started.
Yeah, I visited that school.
And many historical people have visited, like Sarojini Naidu and many others. The names are there. So it's a very nice place with very good vibration.
Yes. It has to be preserved.
That is right.
The Theosophical members, we had some 4 or 5 rooms with us.
Yeah.
In that school. But subsequently, as the school attendance grew, the sections grew, we kept on donating one room by one room. Oh. So now there's only one room in which we meet, and there's a small room in which we are having these ES meetings.
Yeah, I know. Shukla is there, no? Shukla is
yes,
there.
Yes.
Brother Shukla was here. He's not here right now.
No, I am asking in that Indraprastha Lodge.
Yes. He is there. Dr. Sasangi is there. Brother Taneja is there. In fact, Brother Taneja is there right now. Brother Taneja, would you like to say something about that place? IP Lodge ke jo building hai?
हाँ जी नहीं उन्होंने कंचन जी ने सब कुछ बता ही दिया है और ये बहुत इसको ये उन्होंने एक वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज बिल्डिंग डिक्लेयर की हुई है तो वहाँ पे एक वहाँ बोर्ड भी लगा हुआ है जिसमें स्टार्ट ही ऐसा है इन हिंदी इट इज रिटेन ब्रह्मवादी एनी बेसेंट दे हैव ट्रांसलेटेड थियोसोफिस्ट एज ब्रह्मवादी कि ब्रह्मवादी एनी बेसेंट ने ये हवेली डोनेट की लाइक दैट और उसपे काफी लोग आते रहते हैं वहाँ भी जो टूर्स ऑपरेट करते टूर ऑपरेटर्स फॉरनर्स बहुत आते हैं विजिट करने और अभी 2-1 साल पहले पोस्ट करना एक ऋषि कपूर की एक फिल्म थी जो अभी शायद रिलीज नहीं हुई है ड्यू टू हिज डेथ राजमा चावल उसकी शूटिंग वहीं हुई थी एक हफ्ते तक उन्होंने कैंप भी उसी स्कूल में किया था एक बार तो हमारी मीटिंग थी ऋषि कपूर वहीं आया हुआ था एंड ही मेट एवरीबॉडी तो काफी मतलब इम्पोर्टेंट बिल्डिंग है ये हैविंग वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज वो काफी लोग इसको विजिट करते रहते हैं
जो स्टैचू लगा है हमारी फेडरेशन बिल्डिंग में वो भी इसी का पार्ट था
हाँ जी
आईपी स्कूल
वो यही था पहले यही
लॉज का इंद्रप्रस्थ लॉज से ही वो फेडरेशन में गया है
हाँ वहीं गया
पहले वो हमारे पास
पहले यही होता था राइट
इंद्रप्रस्थ लॉज में ही था
और शिंदे जी आए थे इन्होंने एक बार फोटो ली थी तो वो फिर थियोसोफिस्ट में भी आई थी
कुछ बोलना चाहते हैं सत्संगी जी अनम्यूट करिए
अनम्यूट करना पड़ेगा
डॉक्टर सत्संगी जी
बहुत बहुत बधाई हो और बहुत सुंदर वक्तव्य रहा आपका वंडरफुल टॉक्स
Thank you.
And it was, we learned a lot of things about Dr. Annie Besant, about her thought, and our universal prayer, which we recite every day in every meeting. But you have gone in depth to analyze the secret meaning of this prayer, which is wonderful. And every one of us who have attended, I am seeing good number of people from all over the country have attended this and have been enlightened by your lucid and clear speech on such an important aspect of our prayer and about Dr. Annie Besant and also about Mahatma Gandhi. You have shown us the picture that shows how both Dr. Annie Besant and Mahatma Gandhi worked together for the freedom of the country and ultimately became successful. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. So kind of you.
Thank you.
Thank you, brother. If there is anyone else who would like to contribute, kindly unmute and contribute, please.
Yes. I couldn't understand the meaning of the universal prayer today after having spent 60 years in the Theosophical Society today itself. Thank you, sir, very much.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you. So, before we close the meeting, I would like to make an announcement that the next Saturday, Shankar Lodge will not be holding a meeting because of the program by International President Brother Tim Boyd on the occasion of the Sheras Festival. So he'll be holding meeting on 8th and 9th and 10th of October from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. with the subject Personality and the Inner Life, Tuning the Soul's Instrument. So since the International President is going to speak on all these 3 days, Shankar Lodge will not be holding any meeting on 8th. So I thank you, Brother Shindeji, for a wonderful talk, and I thank you, and also thank all the participants who have heard you here and have attended. So we'll close this meeting with the universal prayer. Forward in life, vibrant in every atom. Forward in light, shining in every creature.
Oh, hidden light shining in every creature.
Oh, hidden love embracing all in oneness.
Oh, hidden love embracing all in oneness.
May each who feels himself as one with thee.
May each who feels himself as one with thee.
Know he is also one with every other. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shindeji.
Thank you. And we meet again.
Yes, sir.